In 2022, the World Health Organization estimated over 1.5 billion people with hearing impairment globally. World Health Organization believes that by 2040, the rate will be between 2.5 to 3 billion people if many don't change their lifestyle in use of gadgets, medication, among others. Patrick Egesa lost his hearing ability in senior three. According to Patrick, medication such as quinine that was given to him when he had a fever affected his ability to hear. Patrick recalls the experience of the new world he had joined. He says it was challenging, but he had enough support from his family members.
I also realized that it could be also a family issue because I'm not only one, we are three now in the family. So I started managing it. I started knowing how to handle myself because I could hear. In most cases, when I'm talking, you realize that I give you one ear on the sides, meaning that I want to get the sound and I want to hear what you're saying.
Unlike Patrick Egesa, who is able to hear with one ear, Daniel Mark Newton lost his total ability to hear in almost the same manner. He recalls falling sick with cough and flu, but with the medication he received, he lost his hearing ability. He explains the world of learning lip reading and other challenges he encountered.
The disability is not easy. Oh, it is very hard the way he managed to get the information. It's like someone wants to speak clearly. The lips have to move clearly. There are some people, they use jargon. So when you look at such a person, and he's talking like very fast. So I fail to get that information. I use captions. So when someone is talking, I use my smartphone, even my laptop. It can write for me and records what that person is talking. Then for me, it is writing. At the end of the day, I read. And I understand. That's what has helped me.
Dr. Esther Nagasaga, an ear, nose and throat doctor from Mulago National Referral Hospital, explains hearing loss and its stages.
It can be of different stages, okay? And it so happens that rarely does someone lose their hearing at once. It's going to go through different phases. But we also have cases where people get sudden sensory neural hearing loss, which is usually severe. We have people who have the mild hearing loss, the moderate hearing loss, the severe hearing loss, and the profound hearing loss. So for patients who have profound, that's where we shall call them deaf. Different causes happen at different times. You'll find that even as the baby is being formed in the womb, they can be predisposed to having hearing loss. That's the prenatal causes that happen when the mother is pregnant. And the commonest ones that we look at or we can counsel people about who are pregnant are genetic causes. Now, how do you have an idea or an instinct that maybe I need to screen my baby as soon as they are born? Do you have history of hearing loss in your family? Are people getting hearing loss quite early? Or even the history is there? So for adults, you're an adult like me, what usually gives us hearing loss are predisposing factors like ear infections, receiving ototoxic drugs, like I talked about, people who are receiving, who have hypertension or renal disease, and they're receiving some drugs of renal disease can cause, like furosemide, can cause hearing loss, and it's very common on the market. Quinine can cause hearing loss. Some anti-cancer drugs can cause hearing loss, okay? The commonest that I should have started with is exposing the ears to loud sound.
Dr. Nagasaga explains the signs of hearing challenges in children. However, he says some of the conditions can be treated at an early stage.
So for the newborns, neonates, we want to see if they have a stutter. Okay? Do they stutter when they hear loud sounds? If I bang, would they get scared and try to figure out where, or cry? All right? That's a good point that the child can hear. However, that could also just be the child felt the vibration. So that's not enough. By 6 months, we expect that the child should turn to the source of sound. Okay? By 1 year, the child should be able to say something like mama, tata. At least they should formulate some vowels of things they have been hearing. We need to avoid exposing our children to loud noises, to prolonged loud noises. Even adults, same. We need to protect our ears from exposure to very loud noises. The child prefers loud television volume or phone volume when he's watching his cartoons. There is a problem. Please follow up.
Jackson Mbosi, an audiologist, has explained how the hearing aids are used and how they help people with hearing impairment.
Hearing aids come out in different, I can call it in simple language, power. Some of the hearing aids are for mild power, some of them are for moderate power, some of them are for severe. Of late, we have technology that hearing aids are digital. They used to be analog, but now they are coming out digital. Digital means that you can work with them to program anyone's hearing, such that if someone is mild, you can program it to a mild impairment. Someone is severe, program it to. So hearing aids are now coming out into digital, and we are able to help most mild, moderate, and severe cases of impairment.
We visited Ntinda School of the Deaf, and the headmistress, Tumuhaire Juliet Mary, explained to us that the school enables learners with vocational skills, and the children with hearing loss can acquire trainings in various fields.
We admit children from age of 5 to 18, but we have a program which is done before school, because a child from home does not know any sign language. So that program introduces sign language to the child and the parent or the caretaker.
Patrick Egesa and Newton believe that if government can help such institutions, many children will be able to complete a school. On Friday, March 3rd, 2023, Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate World Hearing Day to raise awareness on how to prevent deafness and hearing loss and promote ear and hearing care across the world. Report compiled by John Mosenze for the news.